by using equivalent mechanical model and the measured sensitivity. I calculated the value indicated that switch failure can significantly increase the adhesion parameter. Also, we measure the quality factor and motion resistance, which can play an important role for power consumption and noise level. As you can see this graph, the initial Q is comparable. However, the reduction of Q per CNT-QCM is much less than their QCM. In general, such a high Q devices gives a stable operation and low interpretation loads. And moreover, the CNT-QCM maintains low motion resistance values. And this low motion resistance value devices gives the golden operating range and low power consumptions. Also, we verified the reusability of our sensor by using simple IPA and DI water cooling system. So we expect that our sensor will be economically beneficial for salinity measurement. To demonstrate future application for closed loop system, we built a custom flux oscillator and measured the limit of detection. The limit of detection is measured to be 40 picogram, and we expect that this error value could be lowered by CMOS integration. And also, as you can see, this graph, the frequency change of closed loop system shows good agreement with open loop system, which means our sensors could be applied for closed loop system. The last mechanism is convection flow. This flow is responsible for particle agglomeration and coupling effect for colloidal suspension drum net. So as you can see this same image, the CNT radio does not improve the particle pattern due to dominant conventional flow effect. So as you can see this graph, the CNT radio no longer improve the electrical characteristic of our QCM sensors. So even though the deposited particle have nanometer size diameter, the particle agglomeration impact in the stable oscillation of QCM. In conclusion, in an effort to improve our salinity sensor, we decorated the carbon nanotube layer on our sensors. And this and changing our structures on QCM can control particle size and particle patterns with dominant heterogeneous nucleation and the suppression of particle sliding impact in evaporation deposition. Such nanometer size of the particles and neutron deposition can alleviate interfacial loads showing improvement of Q. However, for colloidal solution, CNT coating could not improve particle patterns due to dominant convection flow. We expect that our work can contribute to creating advanced system for water quality monitoring, detection of metal ion concentration in semiconductor processing, and even for aerosol particle analysis. This research is supported by Kim and DGIST, and I really appreciate for my professor and my mate for helping my research. Thank you for listening.